Well, welcome back, everyone, to Mindtree's Possibilities Dialogues. This episode is on productizing information services. We have the pleasure of having Chris Stephenson, Head of Product Innovation at Grant Thornton. Chris, welcome back. Well, thank you, Chris, for sharing that wonderful journey with us. Truly appreciate it. I know that Grant Thornton was recently recognized by the American Business Awards with 5 Stevie Awards for innovation and disruption. Your pandemic resiliency assessment tool, your Alex digital problem solving platform, and your SOCX reporting solutions tools were all recognized. In other words, you and the transformation team at Grant Thornton are truly productizing information services, as you touched on just now. How are you doing this, Chris? And what business outcomes are you focused on achieving?
Yeah, no, well, thank you for recognizing that. It was a very proud moment for all of us, and probably the output was more about what we did for the year and a half before that, and when I'm asked what I'm most proud about, it's actually the operating model we built to innovate. I think all 3 of these awards and all 3 of these tools came from a common framework. What's funny is all 3 of them are so different on how they were there. The tool I didn't get all the Stevie Awards at my house, but I did steal one. and the one I brought home was the pandemic award. Because within our operating model, it was the speed to market and the speed to innovate that we were able to actually win for. We actually had our tool in the market 8 days after the US closed down. We Wow. ran 22 development cycles in 8 days. We ran 24 hours around the clock. And we were able to actually put a tool in the market that allowed our clients and our colleagues to answer questions about different cash forecasts, different pandemic impacts, and actually forecast some of the areas and risks, and then come and have a conversation with us. Right, 18 months later, it's probably a little forgotten just how scary that time was, but just being able to allow all of our clients the opportunity to do something, fill out something, and then have a conversation was actually a great way for them to formulate a strategy. So that award was really about taking our model and iterating very quickly. With probably, if I look back, there's things I would do differently if I had 8 months instead of 8 days. But the speed and the stress test we put on there was so powerful. The SOC tool was actually a great example of us productizing an existing service. We have a great SOC business, and our business was our tool that we used was probably one of the most popular tools in the world, called Excel. it's still I mean, what a tool Excel is, but it was also done with macros, a lot of manual input, a lot of inconsistency, a lot of versions of Excel were out there. And so our business leaders came to us from that practice and asked us if we could build a more streamlined, automated way to do that. And that's what the SOCX tool became. Not only did it standardize the tool that everybody worked on, it forced standardization of the process. It has allowed more consistent intake, which is a better way to engage with our clients, and is allowing us to actually systemize how we collect the data as well, making this tool not just efficient for us as a firm, but efficient for our clients and how they prepare for their SOC testing each year and how they update. And we're taking time out of that entire ecosystem right now. So that was a great example of us taking our process to an existing service offering and really trying to find a way to productize a piece of that. We are actually on version 3 now, and every time we're automating more and more of the work, and what we're finding is not only can we do more with less, but our people that are there are doing higher value activities. They're happier, and our clients are feeling more value in it with every hour we spent. Alex was Alex is a favorite of mine, and Alex was there'll be a day when I probably tell the story that we saw it all along. But Alex is a good example of innovation and pivoting as you see opportunity. The original goal there was quite selfish, to be honest. Is in the first couple months of this role, we realized that we didn't have a good voice of our firm on what was needed to innovate. We didn't have a great definition of innovation and what was needed to help everybody run their business. And Alex was initially created to be a central place to do that. It was not an ideation tool. An ideation tool was more about crowdsourcing and finding that one big idea to go after. Alex is what we call democratized ideation. Our goal was to give everybody in the firm a voice so that they could submit a business problem they would have. And our goal was to aggregate those problems. It turned into what we've often called this Uber for business problems, where not only are the ideas submitted in one central location, but they're actually routed automatically to what we call delivery centers. And delivery centers are those that can actually help solve those problems. Well, it started with more of a technology spin of what can we do with big builds and what can we do with some of the intelligent automation factories that we have in our firm and what can we do with even some of the low touch licenses, has now turned into almost 20 to 25 delivery centers that range from technology to business support, to actually procurement support, and we're continuing to expand. So we now have on that Alex tool internally, we do all of our technology support from tickets all the way through big build ideas. We actually are starting to handle our service catalog for all services that are in common from all of our different back office departments. And we're also using it to create the next big ideas and crowdsource new ideas that are coming. So we have a wide range of business problems that come in through Alex, get routed to the proper group, and we're able to connect those that can solve these problems in minutes. Now, some of these delivery centers are solved automatically. Some are solved over months. But the insights that we're getting from this is we really are hearing from everyone in the organization, and we can pick up on trends very quickly. Sometimes we get incomplete submissions, but when we cluster them together, we are actually making very smart insights about where we need to go spend time and invest next. And I would say that my viewpoint on where investments need to be made is very different than it was 2 years ago before Alex. So three different awards that had three different journeys, but what was in common with all of them was what I think is really most important in innovation is we brought the entire firm along. We gave everybody a voice. We made sure we had a complete view of that voice and that everyone could participate. And then we did what we did best. We looked at design options and brought those designs into our existing infrastructure so that not only could we build a cool tool, we could build a cool tool that was aligned to the rest of our infrastructure builds along the way. And so, you know, a good example, just to take this a little further, is we have another idea that came in recently, and we're actually able to take that same SOCX product that won an award, and we're going to be able to fork the code over and get a head start on a new idea that's really an extension of that base. And so I'm a big fan of experimentation and ideation has to be a firm-wide goal. My ultimate vision is 9,000 people in our firm thinking about emerging technology every day. It's our job to incubate those ideas and scale those ideas and make sure that we're building it on common infrastructure so that when we do launch these products, we're launching as one firm and not a bunch of tools that sometimes tie together.